Yeah. And look, it is a changing world, as we've seen with Airbnb and Uber and stuff like that. So, and look, I'm one of them. So I'm a renter. I haven't lived in my own home for maybe 10 years, and I don't think we ever will, and we never want to. But the reason slightly different with us is because I want to rent a $5 or $10 million home, I can rent it for 1 or 2% because there's no market it. So how many people can afford the $1 million Bondi? Everyone. You rent it out in the middle of the summer, price goes through the roof because they're all bidding against each other. So the rents are nice and high, normally 4 or 5%. Whereas say you take a $5 or $10 million property, not many people can afford that. Of the people that can afford it, they don't want to rent it because poor people rent. That's the social stigma. If you're the boss of a big bank or something, you don't want to tell everyone that you rent. Everyone will think you're mad. But the price goes down. So quite often I worked out whatever I could afford to buy, if I was in the right price bracket, I could have somewhere 3 or 4 times more expensive for the same money. So I'd rather five $1 million units and go and rent a $10 million home than go and buy my own $5 million home. But look, the fractional ownership.
Before you go on, because I remember you gave me that piece of advice. It was about 12 years ago. And
did you listen?
Yeah, I did. Good. Absolutely, absolutely. And you know, as a result, you know, it's been really helpful. But I guess a lot of people don't look at property that way. They do think about the rental stigma.
It's the stigma, and so I still do it. So they call it rent vesting now. So if people want to Google it, do rent vesting. It literally only came out a couple of years ago as the main name. And I do it at the seminars, and I'm probably maybe the country's probably most famous renter because I'm a big advocate of it and I talk about it all the time. And I still get up at seminars and I say, does anyone know who hasn't been to a seminar before, why would I want to rent? And the excuses are, wait till you get married. That'll change. And it does, but didn't for that. When you have kids, when kids go to school. Again, it's all the excuses. They're trying to justify their own position for not doing it.
Yep.
And sure, if you want to build your nest and you hate change, worst thing in the world. But if you want to embrace change, so every time we move to a better place. So it's a positive experience. They say moving stressful. Well, we go on holiday. The removalists pack it, they move it, they unpack it, the cleaner comes in, makes the beds, puts the teddies in place, 90% done. Where's the stress in that? So if you always move to better places and you get an extra holiday, it's a positive experience.
I swear to God, you are like a lifestyle concierge.